A shakeup in the Hickman Mills School District leaves the high school and two junior highs without principals going into next year. And most administrators and assistant principals don't know if they'll have jobs in the fall. KMBC 9's Haley Harrison says the new superintendent is cleaning house. Haley?
Well, that's exactly right, Len. Dennis Carpenter is the fourth superintendent here in the Hickman Mills School District in just 10 months. And he is starting his tenure here by refusing to renew the contracts of nearly two dozen administrators.
Plastered on the front page of the school newspaper, uncertainty looms over Ruskin High School principals and other administrators in the district. Superintendent Carpenter is grabbing the reins of this district and showing some school leaders the door.
It's certainly not out of the realm of expectation for him to want to bring in his own people.
Spokesman John Bacala spoke with us half an hour after interviewing for his own job here at district headquarters. March 1st, administrators, high school and junior high principals, and assistant principals were all notified their contracts are not being renewed. Interviews are now underway.
It's not out of the realm of possibility to say we are going to lose some very good people, but we hope to bring some very good people back in, too.
Ruskin High Principal Chad Ryerson chose to leave after 16 years, accepting a job with the North Kansas City Schools. And Hickman Mills Junior High's Jan Davis is out after graduating from the district and working here for three decades. She's headed to Wyandotte High.
It's going to be interesting.
Karen Bushman says parents have been waiting for change since the schools lost full accreditation in the fall.
I hope it's going in a positive way because, you know, I'm not sure if my daughter's going to stay or not.
Jermaine Wilson over at the Smith-Hale College Preparatory Academy is also leaving. One thing that my sources are telling me tonight is that most school districts have actually already filled all of their administrator positions for the coming school year. So those folks who are losing their job this summer and here at the end of the school year, well, they're in a tough position. Reporting live, Haley Harrison, KMBC 9 News.
Thank you, Haley. All administrators were allowed to reapply for their positions. Principal Ryerson could have reapplied, but would have been one in a pool of nearly 50 candidates for the job.